New Testament 20. Who are the Levites in relation to Jesus? First Steps Catholics. Arnaud Dumouch. Institute Angelic Doctor. Who are the Levites, compared to Jesus? In the Gospel, Jesus repeatedly tells his disciples to beware of the Levites but also Sadducees, Pharisees, high priests of the temple. Who are these Levites? And in fact, to understand who they are, we must go back to the beginning of Israel's history. Abraham, we know, is a father who leaves Ur in Chaldea to go to this promised land, Canaan. He has a son named Isaac who himself had a son named Jacob, who himself has 12 sons, and these 12 sons will form the 12 tribes of Israel. Moses will assign to each of his sons a special mission into the tribe of Levis, the priesthood. It means that it will be them in this tribe alone that will be taken the priests who will later officiate at the Temple of Jerusalem, while the other tribes have other roles. So that the Levites, also called Cohen, hence the name Cohen, when a Jew named Cohen is that he comes from this tribe, will take care of the priestly caste at the Temple of Jerusalem. Their role is to sacrifice the animals for Yahweh and to pray for the people. This temple will last for centuries. It is destroyed at some point by the Babylonians. They will go into exile in Babylon, while 10 tribes will disappear by melting among the pagans. The Judeans, who will give the Jews and the Levites them, thanks to the Talmud, will remain, they will stay, they will return to their land a little later. It is they who form the Jewish people today, the 10 tribes having practically disappeared by assimilation. Well, when the temple was re-established by Ezra, they resumed their role as priests in the temple, and they continued it until 70 AD when the temple was finally destroyed by the Romans, by General Titus, who had was sent himself, by his father Vespasian, emperor of Rome and successor of Nero. So the Levites were unemployed. They remained priests. They knew that they were of the priestly class, but they could no longer perform the sacrifice in the temple, since only the temple could receive these sacrifices. Nevertheless, they studied the law. In the time of Jesus, then, in the 30s, they were scholars in the law and people who had an official role, so that among the scholars, among these priests of the temple, some were very arrogant, of where the conflict is sometimes seen, with Jesus. Many do not accept these precepts, because they think the commandments, very fussy they have established, such as not walking more than so many steps on the Sabbath. Do not save his son who has fallen into a well, because it's a job. Well, those fussy commands are ridiculous. These are superadded laws according to Jesus, that the law was made for man and not man for the law, that anyone, if his donkey fell into a well, will seek him even if he it's the Sabbath day, it's obvious, and it's not a sin. Jesus will provoke them by healings on the Sabbath, in order to spiritualize this law, and they will not forgive him.